guess my age by my art.
Cold freezing night. Holy cow!
Why do you always get away with things? It's not fair to.
What are you doing in my house? What are you doing in my house?
I want waffle fries.
The Jesus freak is super weak.
I'm so divine.
Come on, take
wasted potential. That shit crushes your spirit. It really does. It crushes your soul.
My age by my art.
I love looking at people's art and immediately being able to tell what fandom they started drawing fan art for, like, the first time. And, like, a lot of people assume mine was, like, Sailor Moon for some reason. No, it was Creepypasta.
So you guys weren't gonna tell me it's that easy.
What are you doing in my house?
I want waffle fries.
I just had to open up to someone. You understand how I feel? Yeah!
Called her a hoe because she said nobody. You're letting all your fragile masculinity show. I mean, oh my, she's just not any. It doesn't matter how much you act reciprocating. You could buy her a drink, but she doesn't have to reciprocate. And you pay for the date, she doesn't have to stay.
School SketchUps.
Thank you.
Hey, wanna listen to some tunes?
Yo. MF Doom.
Dripping off the meat grinder, heat niner, pimping, stripping, soft, sweet minor. China was a neat sign of trouble with the script digits, double dip, bubble lip, subtlest midget. Borderline schizo, sort of fine, tits dough, quarter wine, order grind, quarter to nine, let's go. Ever since 10-11, glad she made a brethren. Then it's last down, seven alligator, seven at the gates to heaven, knocking, no answer. Slow dancer, hopeless romancer, dopest flow stanzas. Yes, no, villain, metal face to Destro, guess so, still incredible in escrow. Just say ho.
Don't you find it strange? Only thing we share is one last name.
Hey, I drew myself in different styles.
And you found a little band. You told me you fell in love with it, hadn't gone as I planned. When you had to bid adieu.
Is a lie. Them other girls can't compete with mine. You do it so good, you fuck my mind. You pull it out, then.
You can draw. Day 24. 1 minute drawing tutorial. Circle. A little curved shape on both sides. See shapes around them. Darken up that curve. And color these shapes in. Make these a bit bigger. Align that curves at top on both sides. Blending. I use this. Blend these lines. Connect that C to the bridge of nose with blending tool. Blend the curves under. Lightly shade the sides. Blend the circle and above. Eraser for highlight and done.
name, everybody know my name when I come through. But don't nobody screaming like you.
On the bar, this goes to the strippers and the fucking porn stars and them sexy motherfuckers showing shit on the bar.
I usually just make shit because it look cool, but people brain just interpret it whatever way they want it to, man.
Are you poor and cannot afford Copic markers? Consider buying these brush markers. I think I should say this video isn't sponsored at all. However, the reason I'm telling you all to consider this is the fact that it's not $200 for 36 markers. Instead, it's a cool $40 for 48. Why are they cheaper? Probably sweatshop workers and less transportation cost. Now, any alcoholic brush marker will work, but these are highly rated and will work great if you haven't used these type of markers before. Before I owned these, I thought the reason I couldn't color was my tools. Now I just realize I'm terrible. So let me just ask you,
hi, are you an artist? Of course you are. That's why you're watching this video. Do you also think that art supplies are way too goddamn expensive? Well, duh, that's why you're still watching this video. Now, are you wanting to know some alternatives? Duh, you're still here, aren't you? Well, let me tell you, here are the best alternative art supplies out on the market right now, the bang for your buck. Let's talk markers.
Every artist really wants to get these Copic markers, right?
But too bad, sometimes they're too expensive and you're already broke. Remember, you're an artist.
So here are two other brands of markers that I think are really good and the bang for your buck. We got Artist Loft and Bic.
Let's talk color pencils. Y'all already know Crayola, shit's fire. And don't even play with me, don't say nothing about how it's booty and it's ass.
Cause this drawing here?
Yeah, Crayola. Now for sketchbooks, the cheapest one, deadass, just make your own. It's not that hard. I did that growing up. Literally staple sheets of computer paper, that's all.
Interested in becoming a professional artist or animator, but not interested in art school? Well, here's some alternative resources. Number one is Warrior Art Camp. They offer classes taught by industry professionals and everything from storyboarding to illustration. Number two, Visions Art School. Their courses are all online and offer great classes that help you build up your portfolio. Three is CG Master Academy. Their courses mainly focus on 3D animation, but they also offer a ton of 2D and traditional courses. Do you have any resources you use? Comment them so other people can learn about them.
Like Gary Cooper. Come, let's mix. We're Rockefellers. Walk with sticks or umbrellas in the mix.
Like slavery. Told me I was awful and that shit did not faze me. Tell me how I suck again. My memory is hazy. You're my favorite rapper now. Yeah, dude, I better.
Hi guys, I'm going to be showing you some cheap alternatives for expensive art supplies if you're running low on a budget. First, we have Strathmore Tone Tan and Toe Gray paper. It's really thick and good for most mediums. It ranges from $11 to $14 depending where you get it, but you can always use a sketch paper, it's about half the price. Next up, we have Prismacolors. They're $15 for a pack of 24, but they can range up to $200. They're my most recommended item, but you can always use Crayola. It's not as vibrant, but it's really good if you're an artist on the budget. Next up is Jelly Roll. It ranges from about $4 to $10 to $15, but you can always get a white paint pen. It might even last you longer. Remember, you don't always have to spend a fortune on art supplies for it to be good.
I don't want to die. I don't want to disappear. I hate this. I hate boys. I hate my father and my mother. I hate everyone. Nobody cares about me. Nobody stays with me. So I don't want to depend on anybody. But I hate it at the same time. It's a pain. I don't want to be alone. I don't want to be alone. I don't want to be alone.
Don't leave me.
What's this?
It's an art project.
Okay, I like it. Picasso.
Add a little bit of spice.
Did you know that drawing upside down can improve your art skills? It forces your brain to recognize shapes and lines. Instead of being familiar with how you normally draw, your drawing will come out way better, and so will the details. Try it. Erase time. Boom. What do you think?
Essas meninas mineira, vou falar. Tem a semana inteira pra te ver. E a gente vai até lá.
How long you been doing hair?
For like 3 years.
Yeah, that's cute. Can you turn around for me? Yeah. How long you been doing hair?
For like 3 years.
Yeah, that's cute. Can you turn around for me? Yeah. How long you been doing hair?
For like 3 years.
Yeah, that's cute. Can you turn around for me? Yeah.
Ice King!
What?
Oh, you got him.
Nice job, Marceline.
Your constant harassment of the female gender makes me sick.
Don't you think like that? I will love you endlessly. If you'd only believe me, don't you think like that?
I don't think people realize how easy it is to draw a tree. If you can draw a squiggly line and the letter Y, you're already halfway there. First step, large squiggly line. Then medium squiggly lines attached to the large one. Then on the medium squiggly lines, add smaller squiggly lines. And on those small ones, add even smaller ones. You know you're done when your hand starts to cramp up. Then you're gonna thicken up the first squiggly lines that we put down, and then boom, tree.
You do the thing, and you do it right, and you don't fuck it up.
How about a real tutorial? Start with a circle or something relatively circle-shaped. Add a line on the side you want the face to point. Split that circle in half. The ear will go here. The jawline will connect from here to here. The front of the face is like a bunch of triangles stacked on top of each other. Follow the shape of the triangles to get the front of your face. Adjust until you get the look that you want. For simplicity's sake, the mouth is just a line. Leave a little bit of space in between your eyebrow and the front of the face. The eye is kind of a sideways V shape. Sketch in the neck and the details in the ear. Might be helpful to sketch in your hairline. Sketch in whatever hairstyle you want. Take away your guidelines. Add any details you might want. And you're all done.
Face tutorial. First draw a circle, then draw a U-shape for the face. Add two lines where you want the nose to be. Add two horizontal line above the nose for the eyes. Draw the ears and eyes. Add details like eyelashes and more.
An easy method. Eyes. Frown. Two little arms. Feet. Connect. Shade and darken lines. Darken more. Cupid's bow. Done.
There you are. Let's see how long it takes for you to crack.
This is how I sketch an eye during a boring class. And you can do it too. So easy. I'm begging you, don't overthink the shape. eyes come with different shapes and sizes. Two circles, fill one, leave one. Shade. Line. Line, line. Many lines. Connect the lines, but leave some highlights. Shade, shade, shade. Just do what I'm doing. Shade, but also leave highlights. Draw eyelashes. Fast, don't think. Sorry, shaky, filming with my right hand. Don't forget the waterline. And you're done.
Can't help it, I want you. I can't stop and look the other way, cause I know